Today we have to learn the basic operations on Excel. So first in the search box in the start menu we will write Excel. We get the option up here. We double click on it. Now the Excel window will open up. Click on new blank workbook. As I told you in the last class, workbook is the project in Excel. Book 1 Excel, you see the project. Every project can have many sheets. At the bottom we see the sheet. Sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3. If we want, we can change the name of the sheet according to our wish, like rename. Suppose I name it class 7. Okay. Now every worksheet is filled of rows and columns. This is the horizontally running lines are the rows, vertical one are the columns. By the intersection of rows and columns, cells are formed, that is the smallest unit and where we enter the data. The selected cell is highlighted by a boundary, and whenever you select a cell, if I write anything with the help of keyboard, will go into that particular cell. Suppose I write student name, student's name. Last time we also read that we can enter text and numbers as well as formulas in Excel. Okay, today we will learn how to write the text, numbers and formulas properly in Excel. Now you see I have entered student name. This is one text, or you say information over here. Now this information is quite bigger. It is not adjustable to column B. So how can I adjust? Simple. You take the mouse there in the corner, boundary. We see here we get a plus sign and then we drag our mouse. As you drag your mouse, you see the size of column is increased. One more thing we can do is we can just go to wrap text and see how we can enter the information. Means it will be adjusted inside one column or one cell, you can see. Then we can change the style also, just like in any other Microsoft Office applications like Word and all, you can change the style of writing. See here I change the style of writing. We can change the size also, so increasing the size, or we can decrease the size. At the same time you can make it bold, or we can also make it italic, anything. Now you can put colors, like we can put any color inside the box, suppose yellow. Now we can change the color of text also from here. This is border. Since it is, we have borders all around, so you can put bottom border, top border, left border, right border, no border, all borders. This is how we can see a beautiful border coming up, black. So this is about text. These are the formattings that we can do with the text. Suppose we are entering numbers. Okay, so I enter a number 234. Now what are the things that we can do to make the numbers or arrange the numbers? Okay, for numbers, see, we have here anti-angle clockwise, or we can make it vertical text like this. Okay, next is suppose the lot many rotate text down, up, all together. Let it take clockwise. Now here is placement. This is at bottom, means text is at bottom, and this is little bit up. You can see the text moved up, and this is to the upper side. Up, middle and bottom, three places we can put the text. Not only this, the text we at the bottom, left, right and center we have. Suppose right, text will come this side, left, text is going other side, and center, the text is in the middle. So in this way we can place the text also in our document. Okay, this was we can also place the text also and as well the numbers also in our document. Now next is, suppose if the number that I am entering, I want it in a date format. So it's like date. Suppose I am entering a percentage, so I can put percentage. Let's make it left. Okay. So this is how number formatting is done. If I want a number in scientific notation, simply select and click on scientific. The number will change into scientific notation. So this is how the things are for the data is formatted in Excel. Apart from this, we can also format the cells and rows and columns. For that, I have already prepared a file. Let's open that. Go to file, open, then book 1. Okay, so this is book 1 that I have already prepared for you. You see, we have entered names, numbers, and here is the formula. sum v2 is to k2. Okay, so it is like that. Now next thing is, after the data we have to learn how to format the rows and columns. So first thing is, you learn how to delete rows and columns. Suppose I have to delete this whole column, so I will take the mouse at top, you see it changes to arrow, then we'll select it with a mouse click, and then you can go here and click on delete cell. See, cells are deleted, everything is deleted. Or one more thing, once again I select the next one, I can do a right click, right button of the mouse, you see delete. This is one or another option. One more option is, you select and press the delete button from the keyboard. See, all three ways are help you to delete. What about rows? Let's see, same way, arrow, click, press the delete button from the keyboard, or you select, put an arrow, select, press the delete from here, delete cells, delete sheet row. So row is deleted. Suppose next is by a right click, do the right click, delete. So we delete. So this is how it is deleted. Okay, so next thing we learn how to delete. Now we will learn how to insert, means put. For that, simply you need to select a cell, or select a column, or select a row. Here I will just select, I am selecting here row number 8. Selected, you go to insert, insert sheet row, or insert cell, both will give you entire row. So insert sheet row, see, I got a sheet row. Okay, suppose here, next thing, next way, if I select row number 3, here I can also do by right click, insert, so you can insert. So these are two different ways of inserting. Same way column, let's see, can we insert, select the column, and then go to insert, insert sheet column. So you see, you got a sheet column here. Okay, so this is how we insert. Now, suppose, for example, I have done some mistake in while writing the text and numbers. I have to change. So how can I change? Suppose here, this was Abhishek Tirki, but actually his name is Abhishek Singh. So what to do? How can I make changes? Two ways. Either you go, when you click here in A4, you see it goes to formula bar. Okay, I can click here and change the name to Abhishek Singh. Or there is one more method. Suppose this is Adarsh Raj, I can click here, and here also I can make change. Suppose Adarsh Topo, I need. So I can make the change. Adarsh Topo. So you see, we can make changes from two places. Either you click on the cell and make changes, or you click on the cell, go to formula bar, and you can make changes. Not only this, we can change numbers also. Suppose this is 29, I want to make it 56. I have done some mistake, so press backspace and write in 56. See, it is updated. So it will be updated there in the cell. It will show you the cell that you have selected, and whatever written on the cell is shown in the formula bar. Okay, so this is how we can make changes in the data if we have written something wrong. Okay, next is, and the last one is, writing formulas. Okay, in Excel, when we write any formula, most important thing is cell address equal and equal to sign. Any formula starts with an equal to sign. Suppose I give equal to sign. Okay, now first method to write any formula or do any work is like a simple calculator. You know the address of the cells, you just click there, it can give you B2 plus, you can click C2 plus, manually also I can do, like I can write D2, no problem, no issues. Okay, plus, right? And once your formula is complete, you press enter, it will give you the total. Okay, another method is, again we write equal to, and that is, we give the cell range. I write the formula sum, because I have to do sum. Then with bracket, I can write numbers like V2, comma C2, C4, comma. So this is another way of writing C167. One more method of writing is, you write sum and we give the range of cells. Range of cells means from V4, I told you we use colon sign, and till L4 I want to add. Okay, and enter. 432. Can you see the same result? 432. So this is how formulas are used. Means basically you can write the cell addresses. You can write formula with like sum. You can use the basic key terms, use like sum, multiply, divide, like this. Or one more method is simply using the symbols. Like I write, there is a data in here, B4, and then I give the multiplication sign. Just I write, or we can write 40, then the multiplication sign, or the plus sign. Let's do with multiplication first. Multiplication sign, and then I choose any other data, suppose 56. See, so not only this, it allows you to do simple calculations also using formulas also. Like this, we have many formulas that we have to deal with. Let's see some of them. Okay, so first is suppose the formula today. Okay, so what is the use of this formula? This gives the current date. Okay, so how to write is equal to today, then with bracket you write and press enter. See, it will give you current date. Okay, this is showing me the current date. Okay, simply I will click here and go to wrap. Simply I will click here and wrap text. So it is showing. Next is your sum. The sum is used to add. Okay, so how it adds? Suppose we are adding all this from here to here. So how to write? We write equal to sum, then bracket, then we give range of cells from here to colon here. Okay, from I5 to I12. Okay, press enter. So it is for adding. Okay, next is your ABS. This ABS formula converts the negative numbers into positive numbers. Like if I write equal to ABS, within bracket I write minus 23. Sure. And then I press enter. So it will become 23. So it changes to positive integer. Okay. Positive integer, or positive number you can say, rather. It's better. Positive number. So any negative number you enter, it will give you a positive number for that. Okay, next we have to do a squat. Is QRT, squat. What is the purpose of squat? How we write? I write SQRT, squat, and I write suppose with green bracket 25. See, it shows you also how to write an example. And if I write 25, okay, and press enter, so it will give me 5. It gives the square root. It gives the square root. Square root means, square root means, suppose if a number is 25, then what is 25? 25 is 5 into 5. Means it is square root of 5. It is square root of 5. Okay. For example, suppose I take, we have 9 nines are 81. Okay. So suppose 81 is there. So 81 is 9 into 9. Okay. So 81 is square root of 9. Okay. So in this way, square is acting. Okay. Not only this, there are many formulas like if, average, percentage. We can also see formulas. You go to formulas here. Here we have insert formulas. See how many formulas we have. Maximum, sum, average, hyper, count, sin. Okay. So I will show you some formulas more, some more formulas. Okay. Suppose I have to do maximum. Among this, which is a maximum marks? So I do maximum. Okay. How to do maximum formula? Equal to max. Okay. Within bracket, either you write numbers or you give range of cells. Suppose I am giving range of cells. I am using range of cells. Okay. From I5 to I12, which is the maximum number? Means biggest number. It is 94. So this is how max and min works. Suppose minimum, the smallest number from here to here. So just to next one. To move to the next row, you can press enter. To move to the next column, you can press tab, or you can also use the arrow keys to move up and down, right and left. So it's quite easy. Suppose minimum. So again, from here to here, colon. Which one is the minimum amount? Enter. So 35 is the minimum. So this is how we write formulas and how formula work here. Okay, so this is all about Excel, writing formulas and all. Apart from this, in Excel, just we have to save. Let's see how to save. File, we go to save. This file is already saved, so just save as. Suppose I click on class 7 folder. I give name. Suppose I give some name. First class, suppose I need. First class, save. So this is, formula is already saved. Okay. So this is all about Excel. So let's close. Save, don't save. Saved, whatever changes we have made is now saved. So this is all about Excel that we have to learn.